A very good morning to you. It's great to have your company this Tuesday, the 31st day of August, the last day of August. My name's Jessica Amir, Senior Market Analyst with Bell Direct. Well, Aussie shares are set to close higher for the 11th straight month. Gold miners are delivering disappointing results and FMG to extend its rally. But first, let's go to overseas markets. We saw US stocks surge yet again to brand new record highs overnight. Investors are seeking out higher growth assets ahead of the US Central Bank, the Fed, scaling back stimulus, which will effectively increase effective interest rates. The Nasdaq rose 0.9%. The Dow closed in the red, while their broader S&P 500 up 0.4%, and looks set to post its seventh month of gains. So you've got the Fed Reserve being set to scale back stimulus, while you've also got earnings growth supporting stock valuations. So the S&P 500 is on track to post an earnings growth rate of 95% for the second quarter of reporting season, which is the strongest growth seen since 2009. So what to watch today locally? Well, firstly, the Aussie share market will likely rally for the second day. The futures are suggesting a lift of 0.2%. All eyes will be on tech stocks, reporting season companies, and economic news. So secondly, all eyes will be on building permits today. Out for July, the market is expecting a fall of 5%. With that in mind, keep an eye on Brickworks, BKW, CSR, CSR is the ticker, and Boral, BLD, as well as other companies in the building material industry. The third focus today, commodity stocks will be on the radar again. The iron ore price has steadied. It's holding under $160 US, but the shorter term indicators, the technical indicators, are flagging the iron ore price could start to bounce back. Meanwhile, the copper price rose overnight by 1%. That supported the New York-listed BHP, rising 1.6%, and New York-listed Rio Tinto followed. So, Aussie-listed BHP and Aussie-listed Rio could follow, as well as other iron ore and copper stocks again. Meanwhile, the oil price is steady at $69.17 US a barrel. The fourth focus today, earnings results. It seems gold companies are not shining. They're delivering sour grapes. Gold miner Regis Resources, RRL, reported a 27% fall in profit to $146 million. The market expected profit of $156.5 million. Copper gold miner Sandfar Resources, SFR, reported record profit, with net profit rising 132% to $170 million. But the market expected more profit than that. The market expected profit of $201 million. Meanwhile, aged care provider Regis Healthcare, REG, reported profit soared over 2,000% to $19.9 million. What else to watch? Well, companies are going ex-dividend today, including Appen APX and Link Administration, LNK. As for the most traded stocks at Bell Direct yesterday, keep an eye on Fortescue Metals. Yesterday, we saw FMG shares rise 6.6%. That pushed FMG shares above its 15-day average for the first time since July. Now, the technical indicators are suggesting that FMG, that rally, could continue over the shorter term because a technical indicator called the MACD looks like it is about to flag a bullish signal suggesting FMG could rally again. Now, check out FMG's coverage that we did yesterday on reporting season on what you need to know about its upcoming dividend, iron ore shipments, and about FMG moving into green energy. And lastly, here's some trading ideas that could be worth your consideration. Firstly, the drilling company DDH is the ticker. They were reiterated as a buy by Bell Potter with an increased price target of $1.48. That's up from $1.45. That implies 30% share price growth in a year for DDH. So why the upgrade for DDH? Well, pro forma results were ahead of prospectus forecasts. Remember, the company recently listed. Bell Potter also notes that ongoing rig fleet growth should drive earnings growth in 2022. However, you've got tight demand and supply conditions. This presents some upside assumptions as well. As for other stocks to keep on your radar, here's one. City flagged Flight Centre, FLT, as a hold following its results, and City increased FLT's price target to $16.94. So City says that, yes, FLT's balance sheet is okay for now. It's got $400 million in headroom that could last 10 to 12 months. But importantly, City is estimating that the company will probably make less revenue per transaction than before COVID. That's on the back of less online sales and people booking simpler trips in store, meaning global data is suggesting that people are now more likely just to visit friends and relatives and then return to their destination. So most brokers are also cautious of FLT. However, if you're into looking at technical indicators, FLT's technical indicators are suggesting that FLT shares could continue to rally high on the short term and over the coming weeks, but exercise caution. As for other trading ideas, bullish charting signals have been seen in Paladin, PDN, Red 5, RED, and Perseus Mining, PRU. And that's according to Trading Central. Jessica Ramirez is my name with Bell Direct. Stay safe. Happy trading.